Since a lot of you liked my video about Windows 8.1 on this 2005 tablet PC with an unsupported CPU, thank you so much by the way, I'm keeping this installation for a little longer. What to do with it though? Let's try something that's not such a great idea. Connect it to the internet. For some reason the Wi-Fi doesn't detect any networks, even though the drivers are installed, and it works on older operating systems. So let's connect via Ethernet instead. Okay, no explosion. Do you want to find PCs, devices, and content on this network? I doubt this makes things any safer, but because it's not important here, I'll select no. And we are connected. Now let's visit Windows Update. We have to find the control panel first. It's hidden in versions of Windows after 7. Let's see the settings. Let's say check for updates, but do not download and install automatically. Okay, it took a while, but it worked. I thought we had to install legacy update, but we don't. So shall we install these updates? Let's take a look. Let's just do the important updates first. As a reminder, the reason this PC is unsupported is because it has a CPU with a feature that Windows 8 and newer require, called No Execute or Execute Disable. It's a Toshiba tablet PC with an Intel Pentium M CPU from around 2005. I did other videos about it. They are linked under the description, and one of them is linked on the top right corner right now. Anyway, back to this update experiment. Did the updates break this hacked installation? We're about to find out. Well, that doesn't look normal. There is definitely no installation media inserted. Uh-oh, it suddenly restarted. Surely it was just a fluke, isn't it? Isn't it? Yeah, you wish. Time for some troubleshooting. Let's boot up to Windows 7. Thankfully, I kept that OS installed. It was only supposed to be a temporary setup to get 8.1 working. That's why I haven't bothered setting up any drivers on it. But now it's gonna come in handy. What do we reckon? Just try applying the patches again? Seems like the most straightforward solution. And oops, I left the Ethernet cable plugged in, so now this installation is online for the first time. But we don't need it. By the way, if you click cancel here, it will set the network to public, which is akin to choosing no on the sharing question that we saw before on Windows 8. But wait, let's not get too hasty. The update may have reset system file permissions. So let's try taking ownership of 8.1 System 32 again. Applying the patches again, as shown in my previous video. But this one now has an error. And this is the same error you get when you try to do the patch on Windows 10. Something I mentioned in the description of the previous video. So, is all hope lost? Let's just try booting up again and see if the first two patches, the ones that didn't fail, are enough to get this pointless installation working again. Still not working. Some hope is lost. But let's not give up yet. What if we disable the check from the menu right here? It says it's for driver signatures, but it's also for modified system files. No way this is gonna work. Wow, Incredible. So does that mean all is solved? Well, no, because we have to do that on every single boot up, and there are still some updates to go. Speaking of, let's install them. No point in leaving things half finished. And the situation is the same. Can't boot up normally, but can with a special menu option. I decided to install Microsoft Edge with Windows Update. This way we get a decent web browser without going through Internet Explorer. This version of Edge is a bit outdated, but so is Windows 8.1, so it doesn't matter. I also noticed the screen going blank much more often. As mentioned elsewhere, this is caused by the 32 MB video chip not being able to handle anything newer than Windows XP at this high screen resolution. But after persevering a little bit, by opening and closing the start screen several times, you can get the normal screen to reappear. Yeah, baby, let's do AI on a 20-year-old machine. Doesn't matter if it's server-sided. Try that on an Apple Mac of the same age. Yeah, another update, fine. Maybe there is a way to disable driver signature enforcement permanently, but I haven't cared enough to try it. So that was updating Windows 8.1 on an old 32-bit computer without NX or XD. Still a pointless and barely usable installation, but I'm surprised it wasn't completely broken, because these updates are not meant for this machine. I let the Windows Pen input do my outro this time.